I continue to topics of the proof of the Fermat's last theorem. Part 5, Frey's curve. Assume that the Fermat's last theorem is false. This means there are three positive integers, a, b, c, such that a l plus b l equals c l for a positive integer l. Not that for L equals 3. It's not difficult to prove that Fermat's last theorem is true. So L is greater than 3. Furthermore, we can suppose L is a prime number and the integers A, B, C are relatively prime. If A and B are odd, then C must be even. If E and C are odd, CL minus BL would be even. We conclude that one of ABC is even and the other two are odd. Now, the Frey's curve is defined by this one. This is a Wiles transform. So E is an elliptic curve with the discriminant theta equals this one, and C4 equals this one. Well, theta can be calculated by this one, and C4 can be obtained by this one. Let the P be a prime number by proposition 2.1 here, and the definition of the reduction of E modulo P, EP, here. If theta is not divisible by P, then EP is good reduction. If P is not 2, then we have this equivalence by the data obtained here. Not that one of A, B, C is even. So we have this one. By the definition here, the conductor of E is given by NE equals this one. Consider the case P is an odd prime such that theta is divisible by P. Then A times B times C is divisible by P. Not that A, B, C are relative prime. We see that by the C4 here, C4 is not divisible by P. By the lemma 2.3 here, the elliptic curve is minimal for the prime number P. By proposition 2.1, we can verify that if A times C is divisible by P, the reduction EP has a node at 0, 0. If E is divisible by P, the reduction EP has a node at AL0. Then, by this one, the conductor of E is given by this one. Now, consider the case G equals 2. Since one of ABC is even and the other two are odd, we see that this factor is not divisible by 2. This implies C4 given by this one is divisible by 2 power 4, but cannot be divisible by 2 power 5. Now, we just consider the case C is even. The other two cases where A or B is even can be treated in same way. Then, CL equals 0 modulo 32. Since CL equals AL plus BL, from this one, we see BL equals minus AL modulo 4. Note that L is an odd number, and we can exchange it A and B. So we can suppose that AL equals 1 modulo 4, and BL equals 3 modulo 4. Making a change of variables given by this, the Frey's curve E can be written as E prime given by this one. From the CL given by this one, AL given by this one, CL equals 32U and AL equals 4V plus 1 for some integers UV. Then we find this factor is integer and this factor is also integer. Again, by lemma 2.3, the West transform E prime is global minimum. Furthermore, the equation modulo 2 is given by this one or this one. We can verify that the only singularity is at xy equals 0, 0, which is a node. Thus, by this one, we obtained the conductor of E. NE is given by this one. Comparing equation 8 here with equation 9 here, we find N1 equals 2. By theorem 4.5, there is F1 core given by cusp form in S2 gamma 0 2. We knew that S2 gamma 0 2 equals 0. Consequently, Vn equals 0 for any n greater than 0. In particular, V1 equals 0 is not 1 modulo L equals A1, where A1 is given in this cusp form here. This is a contradiction. This contradiction shows the Frey's curve E could not be modular. Conclusion: if the Fermat's last theorem is false, then the Frey's curve E is not modular. This leads to the proposition 4.1. The Shimura-Taniyama-Weil conjecture implies the Fermat's last theorem. In the above arguments, we see that the Frey curve E is semi-stable. Thus, for showing the Fermat's last theorem is enough to prove the case of the semi-stable curves in the Shimura-Taniyama-Weil conjecture. This is what Wiles and Taylor did in 1995. Next time, we will talk about L function of an elliptic curve and the modularity theorem. Thanks for watching. Bye.